Hello everyone. So today in this video we are going to discuss a very important question, that why abstract and final, why abstract cannot be final. Okay, so it means that if some method is abstract, then it cannot be declared as final, or if some class is abstract, then it cannot be declared as final, right? Okay, so I'm making a class is abstract, and if I'm making a class is final also, okay, so you will see that this is not allowed. The class parent can be either abstract or final, but it cannot be both. So abstract and final cannot come together, right? So we are going to see this concept now. Okay, so this is a class, this is a parent class. Okay, in this I am declaring one method, abstract, then demo, abstract void demo. Okay, now there is a child class. Type parent abstract. Okay, yes, now there is a child class which is extending the parent class. Okay, now child class has to implement all the methods of the parent class, right? Because this is abstract method, and abstract method has to be implemented in the child class, correct? Okay, now if I'm giving here the implementation implementation, okay, so now if I this program inside, I will call this method. Now we'll get the output as implementation, right? Yeah, we are getting the output as implementation. Okay, now if I declare this abstract method is final, right? So the what is the concept of final? Final method cannot be overridden, right? If you see here, it is saying cannot override the final method from parent, because final method cannot be overridden. It's like a fixed implementation. We cannot change the implementation of the final method, and abstract means we have to override it. So these two are totally opposite. Keywords are totally opposite, right? Abstract says it has to be override. Final says it cannot be overridden. So that is the reason abstract and final cannot come together. Okay, a method cannot be abstract and final. Either it can be abstract or it can be final. Right? I hope this concept is clear now. Thank you.